Hello student, today we are going to discuss the new topic transition and inner transition matters. In that, firstly we'll discuss the D block element that are also called as transition matters. So what are D-block element? Let us discuss about it. The definition of D-block element we can write as the elements in which the valence electron enters d orbital in penultimate shell, that is n-1 d orbital, is called D-block elements. The D-block element shows the properties between those of s and p-block element, therefore they are called as transition elements. Now let us discuss the first important question in this topic, that is position of D block element. What is the position of D block element? This question is asked frequently in the board exam. Position of D block element in long form of periodic table is in between S block element and P block element. The D block element lie in the group starting from 3 to 12 and it belongs to period starting from 4 to 7. There are 4 transition series. 3D series belongs to period 4, 4D series belongs to period 5, 5D series belongs to period 6, and 6D series belongs to period 7. Now let us discuss the table 8.1, which shows the 4 transition series elements. As all of you may know that the D shell has maximum of 10 electron in its orbit. So all these series include 10 elements. So let us firstly discuss the 3D series, which includes the elements like scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, magnesium, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. 4D series include the 10 elements like yttrium, zirconium, niobium, molybdenum, technetium, ruthenium, rhodium, palladium, silver and cadmium. The 5D series includes lanthanum, hafnium, Ta73, tantalum, tungsten, rhenium, osmium, iridium, platinum, silver, gold, Hg. And 6D series contains actinium, rutherfordium, dubnium, seaborgium, borium, hafnium, meternium and dysprosium, ruthenium and coppersium. Now let us discuss the position of D block element in all whole modern periodic table. It is shown by the yellow colored element in modern periodic table. See the figure very carefully. Now the next important question in the board exam is write the electronic configuration of 4 3D series. So electronic configuration, the 3D series begins with scandium with the atomic number 21 and ends with the zinc with atomic number 30. The argon with atomic number 18 is the noble gas preceding 3D series and its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Calcium, which is having atomic number 20, belongs to S block of the 4th period, has electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. Hence, our scandium that is here having atomic number 21, in which the 21st electron in scandium enters in the available 3D orbital. Electronic configuration of scandium is written as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d1, 4s2. Or it may be written as Ar 3d1, 4s2. So all the 10 elements having the electronic configuration tabulated below. See here in the table, Sc with atomic number 21, titanium atomic number 22, and so on. Here the expected electronic outer electronic configuration and observed outer electronic configuration is shown here. All the elements except the chromium with atomic number 24 and copper with atomic number 29 shows anomalous behavior. Here the expected electronic configuration for scandium is 3d1 4s2 and observed is also the same. Titanium 3d2 4s2 observed same. Vanadium 3d3 4s2 observed the same electronic configuration. Chromium shows expected have expected electronic configuration 3d4 4s2, but instead it shows 3d5 4s1. Manganese shows the expected and observed electronic configuration 3d5 4s2. Iron shows 3d6 4s2. Cobalt shows 3d7 4s2. Nickel shows 3d8 4s2. But the copper shows the electronic configuration expected 3d9 4s2 and observed is 3d10 4s1. Zinc shows the similar expected and observed electronic configuration, that is 3d10 4s2. Now let us discuss the anomalous configuration of chromium and copper, because this is the one more important question asked in board exam. Chromium shows outer electronic configuration 4s2 3d5 and copper shows 4s1 3d10 respectively. Since half filled and completely filled subshells are more stable than incompletely filled orbitals, therefore an electron get transferred from 4s to 3d in the case of the element with atomic number 24 and 29. Consequently, configuration of chromium and copper have only one 4s electron in the electronic configuration. Now let us discuss the next point, that is melting point and boiling point of D block element. Transition elements show high melting and boiling points. They typically melt about 1356 Kelvin. It is due to small atomic size and strong interatomic bonding. All the transition elements are hard except zinc, cadmium and mercury. The last element in all the series are not hard as compared to other element in transition series. They show high enthalpy of atomization. Now let us discuss the density of T block element. Densities of transition elements are very high as compared to those of the S block elements. The density of the element in given transition series increases across a period and reaches maximum value at the group number 8, 9 and 10. This trend can be explained on the basis of small radii and close packed structure of the element. Now let us discuss the atomic radii of D block element. The radii of 3D series element are decreases from left to right across a row up to chromium, and then this radius remain almost constant. For this purpose, we have taken here the values of the atomic radii of the 3D series. The element Sc shows the atomic radius 140, titanium 132, vanadium 122. Chromium shows the atomic radii 118, and then forward the atomic radii remains constant. That is, Mn shows 117, iron shows 117, cobalt shows 116, nickel shows 115, copper shows 117, and zinc shows 125 picometer atomic radii.